giving up on somebody because he doesn't have to deal with you. What you need is to solve the UV problem. But what we had before was that this is an ordinary interaction between the UV and the UV. Now we have new terms. For example, let's not say that this video is happening. As a new term, that means that I can have any corrections to my data, which is just integral of the wave function with the inverse of response. And now I have this very, very exact thing. That is a fundamental number for the video sound, just because it's exactly the same form. So now I have this new correction to my prediction. It's like I'm plugging it into my prediction for the power spectrum. And therefore, now this is what I had done before, P2 and P1, and as I had before, those were divergent with some powers. And this was an AV divergent integral. But now I have a new property which comes up with new correction, that is, which is the PCS2 and the P1. You can see that both of them have exactly the same gate dependence, plus some partial and principal effects of the cutoff. So as you always do in a fit theory, you produce a greater gear, a greater value of divergence, you assume that if your competent has a divergent part that comes with the divergence, that's the final part of the divergent. So this is required to make the theory of new physical prediction. So that is why we are really not measuring anything physical. And the same thing is made for higher orders, capital. Although there's a good quality factor in the two sides of this one, because you can't be done. No, you can't be done. Yes. How do you interpret the quality system? That's a very good question. The principle is that this is going to be back in the beginning. Yes. Right, yeah, so if, as long as you remember the basic from the line, it's the projection of the. Okay, no, okay. So, I know the giant and the dynamic distribution. Well, that is a good model, is that here you have a vector, so it's a big component. Yeah. Vector is always familiar with one you can represent into on the spatial rotation of the scalar, transverse vector, and transverse space extensor. So the vector would be the assembly of it, plus omega, where this omega is your. It's only harmonic current, so there's 2 meters of theta. Because one of these guys. If you can see it, it goes like decays like one way. So this is most of the time zero. This is an interesting story here, but the object of this quality for this is the object of this is when you put the position theory, you typically assume that this is just it's a potential, it's a velocity potential potential. If that's the case, you can take a proper derivative without losing any amount of information, you just take the divergence of this, and all of a sudden become degenerate with each other. So unless you're able to measure some actual vector mode, plus this quality picture, this quality will be completely degenerate, and you will not be able to tell. This is the most random phase, because we don't measure vector measurable quality. If you add more detailed measurements of maybe rotating situations, you can start thinking about how this account is framed, because then we can discuss this story. But the reason why this much out is that actually this one goes to the generic of this particular order. So at any order, there will be only one parameter on top of this. This is a specific property of this perturbation theory, not generic. The generic fluid, all of them would be wrong. So is this rooting a lot of procedure? Rotor on the cutoff case? Yes. So it's, I mean, this rooting is going to define some scale over which, maybe the best, maybe, anyway. I'm not going to rephrase your question in this way. Eventually, yeah, you may guess whether some order of pattern should be appealing.
So I have a moment on the random, and I don't know if that's not so that is going to be some more traffic.
It's a longer story, but the short version of it is that there will be no mechanism on scales of the order of the actual physical cutoff of the field. So this higher derivative of radius will be suppressed by some scalar, which I will argue right now is about 0.9 times something like that. So scale larger than this, everything is local. As you get closer and closer to the cutoff, you start seeing a potential for normality, but your effective theory also breaks down. So as long as the effective theory is valid, the theory is local. And the breaking of the mechanism actually comes at the same time as the breaking of the effective theory, so you know you have to throw away. And this is always the case every time you look at an effective theory. As you go closer to the cutoff, you will, you know, your perturbation theory breaks down, so locality, unitarity, everything breaks down.